Now, I don't know John Singleton, but I've met him. And my interaction with him was an extraordinary one. I just wanted to share with the universe my John Singleton story. Let me set the stage. January 20th, 2009, Washington, D.C. Now, I was down there to shoot a TV show pilot around the inauguration, and the day of the inauguration, my friend Graham and I said, we're gonna get up super early, we're gonna like sleep outside so we can be the first in to see the president get inaugurated.
6 a.m.
I know it.
I can't take it anywhere.
Just behind my buddy Graham and I was this guy and his daughter, his young daughter. We started shooting this shit with them and they were so nice and so kind and so fun. And ultimately, like, I introduced myself to him. The dad's name was John and the girl's name, the daughter's name was Justice. I turned to my friend Graham and I said, I think that's John Singleton. John Singleton, as in the youngest film director ever to be nominated for an Academy Award for Best Director. That nomination was for Boys in the Hood in 1991. That movie was amazing! And he also made Poetic Justice, and he's someone I admire tremendously. And there I was, as this like young director in my 20s, and he's this hero of cinema. And I was like, ooh. That's me, that's Graham. Look, that's John, that's his daughter, that's Justice. Throughout those hours, standing outside in the freezing cold, we got to know this guy, we got to know his daughter.
Check it out, there's the president.
Where?
The white.
Okay.
There's the thing.
All right.
Look around, see if we can get better.
I'm good with it, where's John?
There's the man, there's John Singleton right there.
You can see the podium and the big screen.
Right. You know what I mean? It's funny. Look at that right here in the park.
What is that?
Can you believe this right here in the park?
Oh,
no. So, you know, that bodes well for the beginning of Barack's presidency.
That is open.
History.
We found John had found a. We'd found a. But that was. This is my interaction with John Singleton.
Why do I get your cheap camera and you get my expensive camera?
World famous director.
I'm dropping Casey's camera.
World famous director canotting onto the camera.
I'm dropping Casey's camera. Notice that he put his name on it just like he's like an eighth, like he's 8 years old. Casey had to put his name on the camera.
Graham Beasy.
My man.
Do you remember when we met John Singleton?
The purple line.
Yes.
Yeah, of course. How could I forget? It was one of the most historic days in our country's history. And we got in line. I don't know if it was 2 a.m. or 4 a.m., but it was in the middle of the night. And he happened to be out there with us. I remember we just started by talking about how excited we were. There wasn't, who are you and what do you do? It was just this, everybody had this pent up excitement. And it was just amazing. I'll never forget it.
What's the favorite part of the day so far for you?
I like the yelling and screaming, you know, in the morning. It feels great. It woke me up, you know, and you're like, get in the back of the line!
Dude, I think your battery's almost out.
There's one more chapter to this little story, which is that a few years ago, I ran into John for a second time. And I ran into him and I was a little bit nervous, but I saw him. And I remember approaching him, wherever we were, and I went up to him and I said, Mr. Singleton, my name's Casey. I don't know if you remember. And he stopped and he goes, Casey Neistat, how are you doing? We chit-chatted and he was going on about, he had seen my videos and after we met, he went and saw some of my show then. And it was just it was a special moment because here he is. He's this like director, this screenwriter, this multiple Academy Award nominee. And I was just some funny looking guy that stood next to him in the freezing cold for a couple of hours. And whatever it was, 8 or 10 years later, we saw one another and he knew me and he knew who I was. And that meant the world to me. The life of most, you touch the people around you, your family, the humans you interact with. And then the life of like an artist, like a singer or a writer or a filmmaker is you you touch the people around you, and then you also impact the world on a much grander scale because your art reaches so many people. And with an individual like John Singleton, I was in that latter category of being influenced by his tremendous artistic ability and artistic work. And then by chance, I actually got to know the human in real life. And for as much admiration I had for him as an artist, that was exceeded by the short experience I had with this wonderful human being. To John's family, I can't imagine what you're dealing with right now, but I wanted to share my story of what an incredible experience I had getting to know John Singleton just a tiny little bit.
Summer.